Let us tell you the story of Datia. Datia was a prosperous kingdom in medieval India, which survived until the middle of the 20th century. Situated about 170 kilometers from Agra, famous for the Taj Mahal, in medieval times, Datia lay along the route of the Mughal armies marching to southern India. This palace was built by Raja Bir Singh Deo in 1614. He carved Datia into an independent kingdom by supporting Prince Salim, later known as Emperor Jahangir, in his rebellion against his father, Akbar the Great Mughal. Until half a century ago, Datia was surrounded by dense deciduous forests, full of chinkaras, bluebulls, and even tigers. In fact, in the new palace of Datia, there hangs a picture of Raja Gobind Singh, a renowned hunter, surrounded by 162 tiger skins. The image of the hunter warrior has lost its romance in our times, but it does confirm the presence of dense forests around Datia. And now, the forests have gone. Instead, the hills around Datia present an unredeemed panorama of barrenness. All that remains are folk songs expressing the love of the people for the lost forests. But why did the forest disappear? The reasons are manifold and complex. With the transfer of the forest to the forest department, the emotional links between the people and the forests were broken. As the roads linked the local community to the ever-expanding urban economy, the exploitation of the forest resources was no longer limited by the local needs. It was driven by the needs of the urban markets. Need was replaced by greed. From lush green forests to vast wastelands took less than 5 decades. Datia forms part of the Bundelkhand region of northern India, which overlaps the states of Madhya Pradesh and Uttar Pradesh. The economy of Bundelkhand is mainly agricultural and pastoral. Here, the rainfall is low, and only 26% of the agricultural land has two crops, comprising mainly oilseeds and coarse grain. But the man-to-cattle ratio in Bundelkhand is high, that is, 1 is to 1.5, as against the national average of 1 is to 0.45. In most underdeveloped economies, the burden of fetching firewood, fodder and water falls mainly on the women. Therefore, as the forests and grasslands disappeared, the pressure for survival on the women increased. Gathering a headload of firewood now took half a day, and taking the cattle for grazing meant a long trip into the wilderness away from the family. In India, the government has been concerned about the vanishing forests and expanding wastelands for quite some time. To deal with this problem on the revenue lands, the government of India constituted a wasteland development board a few years ago. On the forest lands, the problem is still being tackled by the forest department. The traditional method of restoring the forests, practiced by the Department of Forests, is to dig pits, raise a nursery, plant saplings, apply a liberal dose of manure, nurture the saplings by water, and protect the plantation from man and animal by appointing chowkidars. This method, though well established, has several disadvantages. The main interest of the Forest Department is to produce timber for commercial exploitation. Therefore, This method results in monoculture plantations which do not meet the needs of fodder and firewood of the local people. The tree species selected are not necessarily local species. For this reason, and because of loopholes in the management, the survival rate of the trees is low and the cost high. It was in this background that a retired Air Force officer, Air Vice Marshal S. Sahni, hailing from Bundelkhand, appeared on the scene in Datia in 1987. Sahni had joined the Indian Air Force immediately after India's independence in October 1947. During his deputation to the Ministry of Agriculture from 1975 to 80, one of his responsibilities was the seeding of ravines in Bundelkhand by air seeding. He took premature retirement in December 1981 and later joined an NGO called the Development Alternatives. As a representative of this NGO, he returned to his old passion, that is, rural development and regeneration of barren land. Sahni knew that the traditional method of forest regeneration was not a solution for the wastelands around Datia. He began to experiment with the technique of natural regeneration.
If you go through the history of forestry in India, there's very little plantation which was done. These forests all appeared naturally centuries ago. So the very fact that area was full of trees gave me an impression that the rootstock would still be there. So if I could, and I was also aware that the recouping potential of ecosystem is so tremendous that if given some respite from biotic interferences, both man and animal, things would come up on their own. Second intervention which we did was to ensure that most, if not all, the rain falling was absorbed in situ, as you can see all this area. And then we watched the fun. And nature did the rest for us, which you can see the forest in 7 years.
The key to the natural regeneration of forests lay in the survival of the roots lying dormant beneath the soil, waiting to sprout. The forests had disappeared in recent memory, and Sahni believed that large tracts of land around Datia would still have the rootstock of trees. Armed with this confidence, Sahni approached the district collector, that is, the chief administrator of Datia, to be given a piece of barren land to try out an experiment in natural regeneration. Luck was on Sahani's side, as the collector happened to be a person who was willing to cut through the red tape for a good cause.
This was one concept which needed a certain innovative style, a certain amount of creativity, a lot of flexibility, a lot of cost-effective mechanism, and which we thought that, well, it is not possible to work within the framework of the government, and we must involve the other agencies who are, you know, dedicated to this cause.
Did you break any rules in doing this?
Well, I would say yes and no. Our idea was not to hand it over, but to regenerate, you know, make it, get back the nature, work on a piece of land, and use certain agency for doing that. So here was one revenue, big chunk of land, which could be given for this purpose of regeneration. And therefore, we gave it in anticipation of the government final order.
The wastelands of Datia are a mere fraction of the larger national picture. In 1985, the National Remote Sensing Agency had estimated that of the total geographical area of India, 16.2% was wasteland. A detailed district-wide study was carried out by this agency 7 years later. According to this study, of the total area of 2,038 square kilometers of Datia district, 623.6 square kilometers, or 30.6%, was wasteland. A large part of this wasteland falls in that category which once had a tree cover, and thus perhaps still has root stock. Therefore, the Datia collector had plenty of wasteland to offer, and Sahni had plenty to choose from. Sahni chose two hills on the outskirts of Datia town, measuring 56 hectares and 37 hectares, which later came to be known as Site A and Site B. When the Development Alternatives took over these hills, they looked like this hill, Pali Pahari, 20 kilometers from Datia, bald and barren. without a tree or even a shrub.
यहाँ बहुत भयानक जंगल था. इसमें हर किस्म के जानवर रहते थे. सुअर, सावर, चीतरा, काले हिरन, ये सब रहते थे. अब जंगल कट गया, अब परेशानी आ गई है. अब तो जो है जंगल है ही नहीं. अब तो छाया तक नहीं मिलती है बैठने के लिए. नहीं पत्थर पत्थर दिखाई दे, पत्थर का पता नहीं चलता था कि पत्थर यहाँ पत्थर है. जंगल जंगल दिखता था.
To help the rootstock to sprout, obviously the first step was to improve the moisture conservation in the soil. Fortunately, Datia already had a long tradition of conservation of water in situ and of protecting groundwater sources. For example, this ancient stepped well was built by one of the local noblemen to provide water to the travelers and the pilgrims. The groundwater in this well has been carefully protected against natural evaporation and other outside elements. In fact, the practice of protecting water sources is also followed in the other dry regions of India, such as Rajasthan and parts of Gujarat. Datia town is not served by any river, but is surrounded by 9 large interlinked tanks. These tanks used to provide water for drinking, bathing, and for limited irrigation for the people of Datia. And even today, they play an important role in the life of the community. Therefore, Sahani's idea of conserving water in situ was built on a tradition of local wisdom. Between May and July 1987, shallow trenches were dug in overlapping rows along the hill slopes of Site A. The objective was to break the flow of rainwater, increase percolation of water in the soil, and reduce soil erosion. Overlapping rows of trenches help to conserve maximum amount of rainfall in situ. These trenches also serve to collect the topsoil washed down by the rainwater. Later, these trenches became natural bins for collection of fallen leaves, which are converted into humus. As a result, the soil and water regime began to improve. After experimentation, the size of trenches has been standardized to 3 meters long, 0.5 meters wide, and 0.5 meters deep, keeping in view the gradient of the slope. On slopy lands, fast-flowing rainwater quite often creates gullies because of its erosive velocity. As these gullies become the natural cause for the outflow of rainwater, the gullies tend to expand with every passing year. Both Site A and Site B had huge gullies. These gullies were plugged by making small bunds or barriers with boulders. In terms of breaking the flow of water and improving soil moisture, the effect was broadly the same as that of the trenches. In addition to earthwork for improving the water and moisture regime, the other problem was to stop biotic interference both by man and animal. For this purpose, cattle protection trenches, or CPTs, were dug around the hills. The CPT is usually 1.5 meters wide and 1 meter deep, with a base of 0.8 meters. On the berms of CPT, Prosopis juliflora, locally called Vilayati Babool, was sown. This is a non-browsable species. As a safeguard against human interference, a few watchmen or chowkidars were appointed. The rest was done by nature. After the very first rainy season, the annual grasses such as Tridex, Dinanath and Aristida emerged. After completing their life cycle, these annual grasses paved the way for perennial grasses from the second year, such as Dicanthium, Hermophogon, Heteropogon, Chrysophogon, and a local grass called Sen or Sahima. The perennials were accompanied by legumes such as Caribbean Stylo and Mimosa pudica, also known as Touch Me Not. Legumes help to fix nitrogen in the soil and thus improve soil fertility. A combination of grasses and legumes also provides a rich forage for the cattle. A very limited seeding of grasses and legumes, particularly stylohamata, was done on stray patches. Stylohamata is a wonderful legume, which can grow in very harsh soil conditions. In the selection of grasses and legumes, the advice of the Indian Grassland and Fodder Research Institute was taken. No organic or chemical fertilizer was used. In a largely pastoral economy, grasses are as important for survival as food crops. Increased availability of grasses and legumes not only improves the health of the cattle, it also directly reduces the burden on women who have to look after the cattle. Once grasses got established, the soil erosion was automatically controlled, and the retention of moisture in the soil was prolonged. The conditions thus became ripe for the rootstock to sprout. The most widely found tree species around Datia are Butea monosperma, or flame of the forest, and Anagesia spendula, locally known as Gardhai. Also known as Dhak, the flame of the forest is a marvelous creation of nature. It blooms in the peak of summer, when the temperature in Bundelkhand can touch 47 degrees Celsius. At both the sites A and B, Dhak began to emerge in the first year itself, but Gardhai sprouted in the second season. All the land of sites A and B did not respond uniformly, as in some areas the rootstock had disappeared due to serious soil erosion. Here, selective plantation of local species such as neem and ber was done. Altogether, seeding of trees was necessary only on about 12 hectares out of a total land area of about 93 hectares. From the third year, self-seeding of grasses and trees started, and even the variety of tree species began to multiply. After 8 years, the hills have become green again, and trees have even begun to overshadow the rocks and boulders. The water table of the land surrounding the hills has also gone up. Bhola, a potter farmer living near site B, is one of the beneficiaries.
जब से हमारा जन्म हुआ है, जब से हमने जंगल नहीं देखा है, उसके बाद जंगल जो है, अभी 10-15 साल से हो गया है, तो कुआं में पहले का पानी भी जो है कम था, उसके बाद जो है जब से जंगल रोपण हो गया, उसके बाद जो है कुछ कुआं में पानी भी जो है परिवर्तन हो गया, उसके बाद जो है जमीन में भी नमी आ गई, जंगल से होने से कुछ पत्ता आते हैं, पत्ती उसकी उसमें खाद भी जो है कुछ परिवर्तन होता है उसका.
Have the results been to your satisfaction?
I think, well, I think all of us can see it. It is today, in fact, I'm coming back after I left in July 87, after handing over the land when it was totally barren. And today I'm really thrilled to see that it has been recharged with even minimum cost, and I think minimum support even from the government, I think. And the best possible thing is, of course, recharging of the water table, which has been a problem everywhere.
The Datia experiment is obviously successful, but what is the cost of development? The estimated cost of all the earthwork and watchmen in the first 2 years was 3,500 rupees, or about $100 per hectare. The maintenance cost now is only the salary of a few watchmen.
Where did the initial funds come for the project?
Society for Promotion of Wasteland Development, in short SPWD Delhi, were the people who were enthusiastic to help us. And once we made these plans, and when they realized the active participation of the scientists and the administration in Datia, they willingly came forward to fund us for this unique project. The Wasteland Development Board initially helped us, as I explained to you, for the chowki dharing. And when the main board came into existence, we had finished the main work here. But we are with them in other projects in Jhansi and Datia districts.
The lessons learnt in Datia are now being extended to the adjoining district of Jhansi. Jhansi is famous for its medieval fort, which is identified with the Queen of Jhansi, Rani Lakshmibai, who had played a historic role in India's first major struggle against the British colonial regime. In Jhansi district, the common lands of the village Dongri have been taken up for natural regeneration. Dongri is a small village of only 650 people, but it is surrounded by vast barren hills. The hills of Dongri are far more rocky than of Datia. Therefore here, instead of digging trenches, small dikes were constructed with local stones. Similarly, instead of digging a CPT, cattle protection walls were built, again with local stones. The earthwork was completed in the summer of 1994. Thereafter, the land had experienced just two monsoons until October 1995, when we began recording the story in Dongri. Already, the cycle of annual and perennial grasses had taken over. In September 1995, the villagers of Dongri harvested a rich crop of grasses, which would sustain their cattle in the winter. A whole variety of local tree species had also begun to emerge out of the soil, and even between the stones, such as neem, kardhai, bamboo, tendu, and bushes loaded with wild berries. So, how do we sum up this experiment in natural regeneration? Obviously, the technique of natural regeneration, with its focus on improvement of water and moisture regime, prevention of biotic interference, and limited intervention by planting local species, has proved to be successful. The cost is minimal, and the results impressive. And yet, both at Datia and Dongri, one important element appears to be missing. People's participation.
आप ये जानते हैं कि अगर ये जो बाहर की संस्था काम कर रही है ये तो जंगल बना के चली जाएगी और अगर आप बचत इसकी नहीं करेंगे तो फिर बचेगा कि नहीं बचेगा
क्यों नहीं बचेगा उसको दिखाएंगे उसकी देखभाल करेंगे तो क्यों नहीं बचेगा बचेगा वो गांव वाले ने तो समिति बनाई नहीं है जब गांव वाले अब समिति बना रहे हैं कि ये जंगल फेंके हो जाए तो बहुत ठीक है
तो ये समिति बनाने की कोई बात सोची है आप लोगों ने
हाँ सोच रहे हैं अब गांव वाले अब तो नहीं सोची थी अब सोचने लगे
The presence of the paid watchman on the Datia hills, even after 8 years, confirms that people have not been involved. This is surprising, because in other parts of India, there are impressive examples of people's participation in wasteland regeneration, though these people may not be quite familiar with the technique of natural regeneration. For example, in the Bankura district of West Bengal, in eastern India, peasant women have successfully organized themselves into women's cooperatives for growing trees on barren land. Here, on Asan and Arjun trees planted on barren land, silk cocoons are grown, the income from which has helped in the empowerment of women and in changing their social status. In northern Himalayas, in the Pauri Garhwal district, a small village called Ufrekhal has been the center of women's movement for regeneration and protection of the forest. Here, indiscriminate cutting of trees had reduced the forest to a field of stumps. Bharti, who now teaches in a local school, had taken the initiative to organize the local women because he understood the dependence of women for fuel, fodder, and water on the forests.
लोगों के बीच में जाकर के जब हमने उनसे बातचीत की तो हमारा पहला कहना यही था कि सरकार की मदद से अगर यदि आप कुछ करना चाहते हैं या दूसरी तरह की मददों पे सोचते हैं तो आपके जंगल कभी फिर से लौट नहीं सकते हैं इतनी अच्छी तरह ढंग से, और यदि आप स्वयं अपने जंगलों को बनाने के लिए खड़े होते हैं तो ये जंगल फिर से तैयार हो सकते हैं अपनी हिम्मत पर अगर आप खड़े होते हैं। तो इस बात का बड़ा अच्छा असर महिलाओं पर आया, क्योंकि जैसे मैंने बताया ना कि महिलाओं का तो बहुत ज़्यादा जीवन जंगलों पर आधारित था, खाने के लिए लकड़ी जंगल से लानी है, घास जंगल से लाना है, पत्ती जंगल से लानी है, और तो और सब्जी भी जंगल से यहाँ बहुत इकट्ठा होती थी, तो वो सब चीज़ तो जंगलों जंगल उनका वो कहते थे जंगल हमारा मैथ है, जैसे हम मैथ से कुछ ना कुछ लेके आते हैं ऐसे जंगलों से कुछ ना कुछ लेके आते हैं। तो जब ये सारी चीज़ें उजड़ जाएगी तो सारी जीवन की जो आधार है वो ख़त्म हो जाएगा। तो इस बात को उन लोगों ने बहुत अच्छी तरह से समझा, और पूरा महिला मंगल दल जब गांव में बन गया, हर परिवार के लोग उसमें जुड़ गए, तो लोग अपने जंगलों को बचाने के लिए शामिल हो गए।
But now the entire movement, which has spread over 100 villages, is being carried on by the women themselves, without support from an outside NGO. Formed their own local informal organizations called Mahila Mangal Dals, or Women's Welfare Committees, for protecting the forests and to regulate their use. Kaushalya is the head of one such dal.
जैसे अपने बच्चे पालते हैं वैसे हमने अपने जंगल पाला, तो जंगल पाल के हमने जब हम जंगल जाते तो हम तो हमारे को टाइम से घास मिल जाता है, बांध मिल जाता है, लकड़ी मिल जाती है, और इधर उधर नहीं भटकना पाते हम अपने जंगलों से जल्दी घर में आ जाते हैं। जब हम घर में आ जाते हैं तो हम अपने बच्चे भी देख लेते हैं या अपना खाना भी देख लेते हैं, हमारा शरीर में भी आराम आ जाता है। तो हमारे को इतना फायदा हुआ ये जंगल बनाने में। जंगल बनाया हमने तो हमने किसी की गाय बच्ची नहीं जाने दी, और हमने किसी को बच्चे को तक भी नहीं छोड़ा हमने उस जंगल में जो चौकीदारी दी हमने।
द पीपल ऑफ उफरेखाल एंड मोर पर्टिकुलरली द वुमेन हैव अंडरस्टूड दैट एज दे डिपेंड अपॉन द फॉरेस्ट, so do the forests depend upon them. Therefore, they have to protect the forests on their own.
Chala didi chala bole jangale bachala, chala didi chala bole jangale bachala, chala didi khaki bodo saja milke jala, chala didi chala bole jangale bachala.
The women of Bankura and Ufrekhal can benefit by the scientific techniques established by the Datia and Dongri experiment. So can Datia and Dongri benefit by the people's participation, as demonstrated by the women of Bankura and Ufrekhal. The roots of Datia do need an improved soil and moisture regime, but they also need people's support and care. Only when these two elements combine would the technique of natural regeneration become replicable and self-sustaining.